It says, Celtic's glorious history is illustrated vividly in a new book entitled Celtic FC Facts and Figures, 1888 to 1981. That's quite a catchy title, isn't it? It costs £1 and is available from the club shop. Research was carried out by Pat Woods, with a tribute from Chairman Mr. Desmond White, who says, it will undoubtedly become, with our other books, an important part of Celtic history. So it's available on eBay, if you like, for £12.99. So I don't know if you have a copy of that, or if that's anything you've seen in the Celtic shop or anything like that. But yeah, as I say, Celtic Facts and Figures, 1888 to 1981. It's not the most.
While we're on Celtic there, Jackie. So at Inferno, how long did it take you to make your mind up when Celtic came in for you?
Not long, to be honest. You know, I was talking about that earlier today, because I think they put a bid in first and then it was rejected, and obviously we were told that Dunfermline wanted £1 million from me at the time, which I thought was mental, considering we were in the league, first division at the time. And we spoke to the club, me and my dad, and it was before, obviously, Bosman. And I got a call later on that day to say that it accepted it. I think it was £650 plus add-ons for Scotland, so worked out £700 with my first Scotland cap. So yeah, it was the just as Braveheart came out of the cinema, and me and my wife lived in Dunfermline at the time, and we were in the cinema to watch the film, and I'm probably the only one that didn't get hyped up or emotional watching Braveheart. I was just so excited about, you know, the next morning I was going through to sign for Celtic and do my medical.
So. Well, listen, I've got a little article from a later Shoot magazine. I'll just go forward to that because it's sort of related to this. So this is from Shoot 1995 November, and it's looking at the Celtic kids coming of age. And there's a little bit here for yourself. And it says, Tommy Burns paid £650,000 for the right back. He's tracked for ages. And the new boy admits, just getting here is a thrill. It's been my dream to play for Celtic. I was so excited after my debut that I slept with my Celtic shirt on. Is this correct?
Yeah. I did. And the kit man gave me the shirt. And as you can see in the picture there, this is before you had your own name in the back and your own size. So this was an XL, but... And it was like a 90 on me. You see, it's rolled up there. And while I was actually in the signing, doing my medical, someone broke into my dad's car and stole my boots. So I was nervous enough to make my debut because I signed that day. It was the 4th of October. And we were done everything there, done the medical, signed. And the gaffer, Tommy Burns, was like, I'm going to start you tonight. At Brockville against Falkirk. You ready? I went, yeah, of course, yeah, brilliant. So went out to get my stuff at my dad's car, which was just parked. Remember the old pylons in the car park at Celtic Park? My dad's car was parked there, and someone smashed the window and took my boots and my shin pads. So I was nervous enough, but I had to borrow someone's boots and shin pads to play that night. I was so nervous.
Yeah.